Uh-huh. So now we skip through. And now, yep, okay. Health gets worse. Hospital. Oh? What's this new music I'm hearing? Okay, so I think because I didn't see Huko's moments before, I have to do it again. A fifth time now. To make sure that... Because now I've seen all the choices. I've gotten all the lights. So now... Right, because the... According to the guide here, the next ending should come after... The hold it in moment, which is when... Nagisa goes to visit... His father before his father gets locked up. Should be. Oh, I just noticed. Yeah, all the little lights here. Okay. And then, yeah, achievements. We got the little. Yeah, obtain all the light orbs. Okay. Okay. So this time for sure. This time for sure. Hopefully. For sure, I hope, most definitely, maybe. Let's find out. Okay. We found something new, fellas. We've hit something new. This is during the birth. Alright, the birth of Ushio. Uh-huh. When you want to save someone. Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. Yep, and this is when he's calling her name as she's, like, fading out of consciousness, slowly dying. I'm surrounded by dazzling light. My eyes simply aren't used to the bright lights after being in darkness for so long. They soon adjust to the fluorescence, and I'm able to make figures out in the background. I know where I am. The bottom of the hill to school. She's there again. She stares at the school gates up above us. I hesitate to call her name. But I don't know why. What could she be thinking? She occasionally looks down at the ground and sighs. A long while passes. She turns around to face away from the school gates. She looks in my direction. She begins to walk. She passes by me, a man she doesn't know. I need to say something to her. But maybe it would have been better if I hadn't. If she had never met me at all. Wouldn't it have been better if the two of us had continued on our own separate paths? But, I... Nagisa! I scream her name. I'm right here! Nagisa turns around once more. She looks at my face.
Yokatta desu, koe.
Really?
Moshikashitara, Tomoya-kun. Watashi to teawanakereba yokatta toka, sonna koto omotteru nja nai ka, sugoku fuan deshita.
Really?
だからもう迷わないでください。これから先と私と出会えたことダメでしょ。No.
I understand. I won't regret it. I'll live my life proud of the fact that I met you.
そうですか。ありがとうございます。
She smiles at me sweetly. Shall we go then?
はい。
We ascend the hill.
ともやくんも団子大家族好きになってほしいです。
Yeah, I'll think about it.
はい。
I look up the other side of the hill, find a world enveloped in light. Nagisa's smile. Her big smiling face is disappearing. Light is so incredibly bright. Wait. Don't go. Nagisa! An even brighter light is in my hands. As if it's trying to surround me. It's warm. I hear a voice, and I feel as if she pulls her hand away from mine. By now, the light has covered my entire body. Whoa. What the fuck is happening? So, like, yeah, we're going down a street. We've seen, like, bicycles. We've seen a road. We've seen these power lines. We saw cars. We saw, like, an alleyway at one point. Looks like some window. It looks like we're going by on a train. Is that what I'm seeing? That's what it looks like. Maybe driving through in a car window. Driving by in a car window. Okay, there's the ocean. Okay, so is this just... This is the trip. The trip that Tomoya and Ushio go on? That's really what it looks like. Because they wind up at the ocean. You know, they were on the train. They were going through from city to city, train by train. They wound up at the ocean. Okay, just some buildings, some trees, palm trees. That's interesting. I don't know, some kind of alleyway or something. More trees. Take you. Oh? Oh? To the place where wishes are granted. Okay. Yeah. It's coming to an end. The town is taking me there. And then, this long, long journey will end. It sure has been a long journey. I reach out my hand. Together, with the countless stars. Okay, was that movie necessary to be that long, though? Like, I'm assuming good ending here, but did you need to make the movie that long? Of, like, I mean, I guess to, like, kind of, I don't know, maybe. Whatever. I'm grasping it. Nagisa's hand. The hand I thought had disappeared. Ahead of it, I see Nagisa staring at me. Yep.
Tomoya-kun.
Nagisa's voice. The voice of the woman I love. Nagisa. My voice is hoarse as I reply.
どうしましたか? Tomoya-kun.
No. It's nothing. I hold her hand tightly. Nagisa grips my hand in return.
ありがとうございます.
For what?
ずっと握っていてくれて.
No. This is all I could ever do for you anyway.
ありがとうございます.
She repeats the words. Hell yeah.
よく頑張りましたね。
I hear Yagi-san's voice behind me. And same to you. You did a good job, I hear the old man say behind me.
Tomoya-san, 牛を産湯につけてあげてくれませんか?
Oh, okay. Yes, that is what my first duty as a father should be. I gently place Ushio in the baby bath drawn by the old man.
Tomoya-kun, 頑張ってください.
Nagisa's there watching me, too. Don't worry, I've got this. I may say that, but I feel nervous.
首に手を添えてあげてくださいね。 左手で支えながら、右手でお湯をかけるんです。
Snai-san teaches me how to do it. I pour the lukewarm water on the small body in my hands, just as I'm told.
頭はまだ濡らさない方がいいですね。ガーゼで拭いてあげてください。
I'm done cleaning Ushio's body. I wipe her with a soft towel as if I'm caressing her, and then dress her. The life in my hands is so small and fragile, yet there's life within it. New, robust life. Ah. As the realization grips my heart, I notice something else. Can't believe how strong she must be. She now has a path ahead of her. Maybe a treacherous one. And regardless of how long it may be, I know she'll travel it living with strength. That's how it's starting to feel. Yeah. She's Nagisa's child, after all. Of course she's strong.
Tomoya-kun, お疲れ様でした。
Nagisa's words of gratitude.
Tomoya-kun.
After them, she says my name as if she's noticed something. What is it?
窓の外、見てください、とても綺麗です。
What? I walk toward the window and part the curtains. Snow. In spring? No. It's the lights. Light. Light everywhere.
もし、街に、人と同じように、 意志や心があるとして、そして、そこに住む人たちを幸せにしようって、そんな思いでいるとしたら、こんな奇跡も、そんな町の仕業かもしれないです。Oh,
there are a lot of other miracles waiting for us from now on. At least that's how I'm starting to feel.
でも、それは奇跡じゃないですよね。町を大好きな人が町に住み、 人を好きな街が人を愛する、そんな誰にでもある感情から生まれるものです。この街だけじゃないです。どんな街だってそうです。私たちは街を愛して、そう思います。Hey,
did you say that the town is one big family?
はい。街も人もみんな家族です。
Oh.
団子大家族です。
Oh. I see. That's how it was. Could she have known that since we first met? No, I'm sure she's known it for longer. That's why she can't hate anyone. She works hard for everyone's sake. Because they're her family.
Tomoya-kun もそろそろ団子大家族好きになってほしいです。
I already love them, Nagisa.
本当ですか?
Yeah. Seriously?
はい、団子、団子。
Nagisa begins to sing alone. I can't help but laugh. Then I join her mid-song. Let us sing forever. Let my memories from this day on be for this child and for this town. Hell yeah. Thank you. God damn. I'm curious to see if there's some epilogue to it. I kind of just want to sit here and enjoy the song, but also I don't want to, like, just sit here in silence, you know? Okay. We're gonna get some special illustrations, so I ain't skipping shit. Good. Good to know. Man. Aww. So sweet. Okay, now it's just the actual scrolling credits with all the CGs in the background. Yep, all the other girls. Big man himself. That's my guy. Aww. Meeting her, what, that'd be her great-grandmother? They go back to visit his pops and his great-grandma, that's... Yep. Yep, here comes the epilogue. I figured there was going to be a little bit of follow-up. Let's see what we got.
Magarimakuri desu. Sakki no hito wa totemo shitsurei desu. Fuuko, shougakusei janai desu.
Fuu-chan, karada chiisai kara machigaerarete mo shikata ga nai yo.
Karada ga chiisakute mo otona no fuukaku de kizuite hoshii desu.
Fuu-chan, 自分が思ってる以上に大人の風格ないよ
今の言葉胸に突き刺さりました ふうこ傷つきました もう傷物です
She's damage cats now
変な言葉使わないの
ふうこ大人です
あ、それじゃない 自分のことをふうこっていうのが
なんて言えばいいですか あたいですか
ねえあたい もう十分大人なんだよ! エッチです!
自分で言って自分で突っ込まないの? 普通に私 ていいと思うよ。
私って、ねえ私、もう十分大人なんだよ。エッチです。
そのセリフだとどう言ったってエッチだと思うよ。
ふうこ、お腹が空きました。
もう諦めたんだね。
ファミリーレストランに行きたいです。
うん、検査終わってから行こうね。
もうふうこ、体どこも悪くないです。なので今から行きます。
ダメ、
早く行かないとハンバーグがなくなってしまいます。
たくさんあるから大丈夫。
一週間前からみんながハンバーグを頼み続けていたらなくなります。
そんな偶然ないから大丈夫。
そう言ってフーコに検査を受けさせるつもりです。
フーちゃんがそう言って逃げようとしてるだけじゃない。
そうとも言います。
That may also be true. I love this little shit.
そうとしか言えないの。
It's the only thing that's true.
なかなか手厳しいです。
Oh god.
さすがお姉ちゃんです。
もうふーちゃん、わけわかんないこと言って、あんまりお姉ちゃんを困らせないでね。
時にふーこのクレバーさは人を傷つけてしまうそうです。
言ってるそばからわけわかんないこと言わないの。ほら、もう病院すぐそこだよ。ハンバーグがなくなってたらお姉ちゃんが作るから。
冷めない鉄製のお皿で出てきますか。
出します、出します。
なら仕方がない。
それにね、体が悪くなくても健康かどうかをちゃんと定期的に調べないと、健康だって言われたら安心して過ごせるでしょ。フーコが健康だって言われたらお姉ちゃんも安心できるからね。
フーコ、心配かけてますか。
え、うんうん、そんなにはかけてないよ。
全身解剖して安心してください。
またわけわからないこと言わないの。定期的に検査受けてくれるだけでお姉ちゃんは安心。
そうですか。では早く行きます。お姉ちゃん歩くの遅いです。ちゃっちゃと行きましょう。
ほんとこの子はもう。
Hell yeah。
って言ってるそばから立ち止まらないで。ふうちゃん、
こ匂いがします。
ハンバーグの。
お姉ちゃんと一緒にしないでください。
今の必死にふうちゃんに合わせてみたんだけど。
失礼です。もう一度言い直すので、何の匂いか聞いてください。
はいはい。
匂いがします。
何の。
この匂いは可愛い匂いです。
それ答えになってないよ。
ニュアンスで分かってほしかったです。
I hoped you'd be more intelligent to pick up on the nuance of the statement.
失礼です、アートです。
またわけわかんないこと言ってる。ふーちゃん、自覚ある？
I love her so much.
お姉ちゃんは学校の先生だったから現実的すぎるんです。
お姉ちゃんは美術の先生だったの。アート、わかる。
なら風子の言うことを捉えてください。
捉えどころがないです。
そうですか。なら現実至上主義のお姉ちゃんにわかりやすく言います。
そうしてもらえると
助けましょう。ではもう一度言うので、何の匂いか聞いてください。
はいはい。
誰かがいます。
え？
え？じゃない。
質問変わってるよ、今の質問に。
そうです。
それだとお姉ちゃん。
大丈夫です、フーコがフォローします。もう一度行きます。
はい。
誰かがいます。
何の匂い。
きっとフーコに会いに。
全然フォローしてくれてないよ。
どうして驚いてくれないんです。誰かがフーコに会いに来たって言って。
どうかこんな子でも
Please God, let this girl make lots of friends someday. Oh, I fucking love you, Fuko. Oh, Fuko's the fucking best. Whatever.
もう文脈めちゃくちゃだよ。そこで眠っています。誰かに起こされるのを待ってですので、行ってきます。え、ふーちゃん？お姉ちゃんも会いたかったら早く来てください。誰がいるの？わからないです。でもとても可愛らしい子です。ふーちゃんってば、ふーちゃん。本当あの子はもう。
Hell yeah, she can. Oh, that's my little homie right there.
いますか? フーコです。 あなたのお名前は何て言うんですか? 教えてください。 フーコとお友達になって一緒に遊びましょう。 楽しいことは これから始まりますよ。
Fuck yeah. Oh. Wait, is that the shape that the lights were making? Cause like the one girl, right, said she wouldn't be able to come to this world, but I guess this was part of the miracle. But then you recall Akio coming to this forest, right, this wooded area, praying for his child, bringing Nagisa to the area, praying that his child survives, right, and that's where a miracle occurs, right, and she does pull through. I see vaguely how, like, all these things are connected. Because this is the girl from the other world, right? It's not Nagisa, clearly. It's not Ushio. It's not anyone we've seen before. This is that girl. And somehow we were able to pull her back through to this world? I don't know, I could... Right, because this is the world of the humans. The lights we were seeing were this girl's thoughts and shit. I don't know exactly what to make of that. We did it, we finished the game, right? We hit the true ending. Yo, we got the happy ending. The family got to come together. Yo, Nagisa survives the birth. They get to be a family. They get to watch their child grow up. They get to spend time with their parents and whatnot. Everyone, it's all good for everyone, right? At least everyone involved in, like, yo, Nagisa's story. So, like, if we think back, like, what kind of ending did Kotomi get out of this, right? Like, I mean, I guess she got a degree at some overseas college and did something with it. I don't fucking know. But, that leaves me with a lot of questions. I ain't go front. That leaves me with a lot of questions. But, yeah, we got not technically I didn't get all the CGs. There's one Fuko one. There's the one where you don't pursue, like, anything romantic with her. That you can see something there. Yep, there's the lights, there's the cold. Uh-huh. The ending illustrations, right? Akio and Sanae. That's nice. Yeah, I'm gonna be honest. I don't know what to make of that. I don't know what to make of that sudden realization there. That's interesting. Like I said, I only vaguely, like, understand how, like, all these things are connected. I don't know, man. I don't know. But anyway, we did it. We did it after 6 fucking months. I had no idea that CLANNAD, it was going to be as big of an undertaking as it was. I had no idea going into it that this was as long of a story as it is. Had no idea. Had no idea. I think, like, if we count Umineko as 2 parts, like, it's longer. This has been a longer playthrough than either of those parts were. Obviously, I think Umineko as a whole was a longer playthrough because of how just fucking long that story is, but this is longer than either of those parts are, and those are separated into 2 playthroughs. This was a long-ass journey, but we finally reached the end. And, God, I love this story. Let me just say that straight off, right off rip. I love this. This was fucking amazing. This was such a phenomenal fucking story. Like, there's a lot of things I'm still trying to process about all of it. And I might even do, like, a deep dive into see, like, some other people's theories and opinions as to how everything is connected and comes together. But this truly was a phenomenal story. I am so glad I finally gave it a chance after all this time. Because it's one that I had seen a lot. It's one that I had heard of. But for the longest time, I pushed it away simply because of the art style. It's not one that I typically like or enjoy. Like, the really enormous eyes on a small face. Like, that kind of shit usually, like, weirds me out a bit. Especially how Nagisa looks on, like, the typical cover art for the game. You know, I always saw the art style, and it just kind of kept me from playing it, because I felt it was just a bit too wacky. Never wanted to give it a chance. I'm so glad I finally did. I am beyond glad I finally gave this a chance, because fucking insane. Fucking insane. Alright, so the breakdown, right? There were a lot of routes in this. Overall, like, I think, if I, like, honestly, this is one of those games that no matter what faults it had, it was such an emotional experience for me. I'm calling this a 10 out of 10. This is easily a 10 out of 10. The amount of times this fucking game got me in my emotions, both good and negative. It made me feel the opposite extreme. The extremes of both ends of happiness and sadness. There were points where I was fucking weeping like a baby. There were points where my stomach hurt from laughter, right? This game made me feel all the emotions and everything in between. There was anger. There were plenty of times where I got angry at what was going on with the story. There was so much going on. So, like I said, right off rip, no matter how I break this game down, no matter how much I analyze any other part of it, the routes, the music, the art, no matter how I break it down, no matter what faults I could pick out on it, I'm calling this a 10 out of 10 because it was just such an incredible experience. It was phenomenal, and fuck, if I could reread this for the first time all over again, I would fucking do it because it was fucking amazing. But yeah, like I said, even still, the art style, it definitely grew on me, alright? My one friend that really suggested this to me and, you know, was the big deciding factor that got me to, you know, play this game. You know, he said he had the same issue where, like, yeah, at first he was, you know, kind of turned off by the art style, but it definitely grew on him, and I agree. If you've been putting this off because of, if you have ever put off this game because of the art style, it absolutely grows on you. You absolutely get used to it. It's not something that's, you know, really off-putting. Definitely got used to it very quickly. The music was good. It wasn't like a highlight of the game, but it was good, right? Don't get me wrong, it was good. Definitely hit in some strong moments. I wouldn't call it a strong point of it, though. The opening and ending songs, they were all right. Nothing that really grabbed me specifically. I liked it, but it wasn't anything amazing, but definitely didn't dislike it. And then there's all the routes, all right? Then there's all the routes. You know, let me just pull up the guide here and let's just take it from the top, right? So, yeah, no, starting with the guide. Oh my god. Misai's route. Even after all of this, I still don't know what the fuck happened there. I get it was somehow connected to the lights and everything, and somehow the cat was a part of that. And I still don't know what to make of Masai's route. I like Masai as a character. Don't get me wrong, she was a good character. Masai's route, awful. Fucking awful. I mean, the majority of it was okay, but that ending fumbled so hard that I can't look back on that route positively. Tomoya, amazing. Like, that's fucking very well done. Very much enjoyed every step of that process. It was definitely one of those routes, like I said, that had your extremes in both directions. Gut-busting laughter, but also, like, really hard-hitting emotional moments. Didn't quite bring me to tears as some of the other ones did, but it was definitely solid, and I definitely really enjoyed it. Yukine, that one was just kind of average. It was good. I didn't feel it was anything truly special, but it was good. Definitely liked it. No big issues with it, but also wasn't anything mind-blowing. Kotomi's route, the sleeper hit, fucking phenomenal, amazing. Once again, I'm gonna repeat it again because it's just a key point as to a key part of the game that I really love. The opposite ends of the emotional spectrum in terms of happiness and sadness. Holy fuck. Giggling like an idiot to just absolutely tear-streaked face. Fucking holding it back, fucking watching some of those scenes. Call to Me's route, phenomenal. Sleeper hit, had no expectations going into it, and it blew me away. Absolutely loved it. Kyo's route, I think this game has kind of reinforced the fact that I just don't like twin romance stories. That, like, I like Kyo as a character. She's alright. I don't love her that much, but I don't like twin romance stories. Ryo's route, even though it was much shorter than Kyo's. I mean, technically they're the same route, it's just separate endings. But Ryo's ending, honestly, I liked it so much more. I just did. Wasn't a fan of Kyo's route. Like I said, like Kyo as a character, but the route itself, it was eh. It was mid. Wasn't awful, but it was quite mid. Kape's route, it kind of in the same bag as Yukine's. It was alright. I liked it. I appreciated the messages it was trying to send. It was really good. But nothing really mind-blowing. Some strong moments for sure, but nothing, you know, truly amazing. Mei's route, I think, falls into the same category. It was good. Definitely had some strong moments. But once again, nothing that was truly amazing about it. Huko's route, come on, y'all know at this point. Huko's my little homie, and I think the one moment where I might have cried harder was when Nagisa died giving birth. When Tomoya is like trying to continue talking to her as the life slowly fading from her eyes, and he's like sitting there, right, you know, telling about, you know, the amazing future they're gonna have. Just hold on, babe, we'll make it. Just think of the, you know, all that. I think that's probably the only time I cried harder. But Huko's route, holy fuck, that ending. Like, I don't think any story has made me cry quite that hard. I know I got emotional playing Muv Luv Alternative, right? And I know that's what a lot of people might use for a reference point, but no, that Huko's route, that ending, the wedding scene, phenomenal, loved it. Yeah, we're not even gonna worry about Komura's route, because that wasn't really a route. Komura's route is essentially a bad ending if you fuck up Nagisa's route. That's really what that is. That's what I've discovered. Like, yes, it is something necessary to get the true ending of the game, but also, it's really just, I see it more of a negative than a positive. I'm not really gonna justify that as a single route. And then, of course, we can't judge Nagisa's route without, of course, including the after story. That's all one big bundled up thing. And God, what a wild fucking ride that was. From start to finish, what a wild fucking ride. Phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. The main route itself was really good. I liked it. Just that main school route during the school year, it was good. I really enjoyed it. Mainly, I loved it so much because of Nagisa and her family. But comparing it to other routes like Tomoyo's and Kotomi's and Huko's, I wouldn't say like that route alone, if we're judging it without the after story, quite holds up. I love Nagisa to death, but I don't think it quite holds up. But then we look at the after story, and that is... holy shit. Holy shit, dude. It's fucking phenomenal. Fucking amazing. Everything I wanted and more. I will say, obviously, my brain is kind of confuzzled at the true end. Like, I'm just going to sit back and say the true end of, like, A, everyone lives together as a big happy family, and just kind of be like, this girl showed up and I'm not going to ask too many questions about it. We're not really going to acknowledge that part, because that's the part that really kind of fries my brain about it. But God, the after story was amazing. God, the after story was amazing. Truly was. Truly, truly was. But yeah, with that being said, that is going to do it. That is the end of our CLANNAD playthrough. So in the next recording session, we will start up a brand new playthrough. It's been a long time coming. Like I said, I've been at this for 6 months. I didn't realize that. I didn't realize I've been recording this for 6 months. I started recording at the end of February. It was like February 20-something when I started recording CLANNAD. And today, as of this recording, it is August 18th. And... because I remember I was going to make some kind of joke online about like, oh, look how I spent my summer. And it was just going to be like, oh, yeah, it was just CLANNAD and Fire Emblem all summer long. But then when I looked at like when I started the games, I was like, holy shit, I have been playing CLANNAD for 6 months. I spent a whole half of my year playing this game. That's legitimately fucking insane, dude. That's so fucking wild. And that's the thing, that's just how good this story was, is that it didn't even feel like 6 months had gone by. It felt like I've been playing it for a few months, right? It felt like I'd, you know, really just kind of dip my feet into the game. The game didn't feel, I didn't feel tired of the game. It hadn't grown old, it hadn't gotten stale. I wasn't sick of it, I wasn't really waiting for it to end. It was just so good that I was locked into it. And just kept going and kept going. Never once really thinking about where the end was. I was just, the end will come when it comes. And until then, I'm just going to enjoy the fucking ride. And I really did. Really, really did. But yeah, like I said, that is going to do it for this playthrough. So thank you everyone who watched. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope I'll see you in whatever it is I play next. But until then, peace.